Hello friends, this is Frank from Germany and welcome in my basement. I would like to introduce you to my new project. I am all too satisfied with my old 3D printer, but it's time for a new do-it-yourself model. We don't really need much. I have spent about 100 euros on all the parts. Here are all the parts you need for the frame. We need 3 times of Panhead screws. M5 and 8 mm long, M3 and 10 mm long, and M3 and 20 mm long. Then, of course, the 3D printed parts. All STL model files can be found in the link of the video description. Very important, but hard to get M5 hammer nuts for fastening on the aluminium profile. Some of ball bearings for guiding the timing belts. Profile brackets for the frame. Plastic bearing from Egos for the X-axis. In the end, we still need the aluminium profiles. I have ordered these in the internet, cut to length. Of course, good rods for the Y-axis must not be missing. So let's start. I set up the camera and try to document everything. Sometimes you will only see photos or I describe simple steps here in this video. To print the required parts, I used Avistron Acer filament, which is very stable and not heat sensitive. I printed at 240 degrees and adjust the heat bed to 100 degrees on a carbon plate with 50 mm in a second. It can be printed at 40% infill. So, well, start with screwing the frame together. First, I check if all profiles have the correct length. Then it goes to the basic frame. Here I build up the side parts, which will hold the Y-axis later on. The assembly is very simple. Simply slide an M5 and 8 mm Panhead screw to the hole of the angel and fix it with a hammer nut. Fix the bolting and the groove of the profiles and so on. In my sheer hard work, anyone can do that. Very importantly, at this point, I check if all profiles lie flat on the table and nothing is loose. If you do, you have to loosen the corresponding angles again and adjust the feet. So, here's an example of how I put up such an angel that can become a fumbling. Especially, I'm not a fine motorist. I ignore the good words at first. It took me a while to realize that they are not needed for the step. But I have already prepared the holder for the guide rods of the Z-axis. Screw the screws with D-part hammer nut together and then fasten it to the profile. Since I only had photos available, I had to remove the parts and put them back in the right place. But what don't you do for your hobby? I noted that the guides are much too short, so this is going to be the Y-axis. So let's get to the Y-axis. Here are the parts we need for it. Three normal bar holders and one where you guess where it's the right place for this. And so on the frame. Believe me when I say this was not the first time I put the mounts on it. We did it! In the end, your frame should look like this. Here's an example of how you build the plastic bearings from Egos into the support. Just push them in and you are done. I had to print out the brackets 1% larger. Now install the bearing brackets for the X-axis in the carriage, but do not tighten the screws too much. We'll do that later, right on the guide rods. Here you can see the printed side parts of the X-axis with the attached ball bearings, which serve as guide for the two set belts. The almost completely assembled X-axis with carbon guide rods and side panels. At the end, we want to mount the bearings for the Z-axis. Here we use simple linear bearings. Press these neatly into the 3D part and then screw them to the bridges. The Z platform simply needs to be screwed to the brackets. Preferably lay all the profiles flat on the table and screw tight so that it's even and straight at the end. Here the Z-guide for the nut is attached to the profile. The Z-motor mount for the stepper motor, like all other parts, is best screwed to the frame in the middle. Here I'll show you how I try to fix the engine for the XY to the frame and how many times I drop the screw. And you can see me in my eyes, full concentrated. The guides for the toothpick presented me with a small problem. We need here M3 screws with a length of 35 mm. A little bit too special for me, and I have to order this at eBay. Hello friends, this is Frank from Germany, and you see, that's the finished Hypercube. The next season will display as electronics and other things. Yeah, and I think maybe next week I want to publish the episode 2. I hope you enjoy it. Bye bye.